Hi, yes, and in this video I want to show you how to use your SD card as internal memory for your Samsung Galaxy A01. Recently I've purchased this, and as you can see, I've used up almost all my memory just on updates. I have not actually downloaded any special apps. But before you skip, you would need a computer or a laptop, as well as your charging cable that's come with your device. I'd also like to mention that if you stay until the end of the video, I would love to show you an opportunity where you can make a full-time income doing part-time work from your cell phone. But let's jump into my computer screen and let me show you how to follow the steps first.
As you can see here, when I click on settings and then on device care, my internal storage is full. First, insert and format your SD card, which can be up to 512 GB, by pushing the metal pin into the small hole on the right side of your phone to eject the SD card tray, and then placing the SD card in the tray as shown. So let's get started with setting up your SD card to work as internal storage. You need to go to your phone settings. I've placed a red arrow for reference. Next, scroll down to device care. We want to enable the developer options, so click on about phone and then software information. Scroll down until you find the build number, and you need to click on it 7 times to enable the developer options. To see if this has been done successfully, just click on the back arrow in the top left hand corner and scroll down to the bottom, and you will see developer options has been enabled. Now turn on USB debugging as indicated with the red arrow, as well as the developer options. You can now connect your device with the USB cable to your laptop or PC, and make sure to allow access from your PC or laptop on your device. Next, on the drop-down menu at the top, click on Android Systems, and for some reason this only works when you enable transferring images, so make sure to do that. For now you can put down your phone, as we won't be needing it for a while. Open up your browser. Now below this video I've placed all the links, so you don't have to type them, but you can simply copy and paste them. Or if it's a clickable link in blue, you can just click on the link. We need to go to Google Android repository and download the zip folder for the ADB debugging tools. This should start automatically. Here you can see in my browser I've clicked on the link and it's downloading the zip file. As you can see, it's been downloaded to my download folder, and you can extract it to anywhere you want. This may take a bit of time, so just let's give it time to finish. Okay, now go to your C drive, and I know I might get a bit of flack in the comments for this, but if the folder is not named correctly, the next steps will not work. So in C drive, create a new folder called ADB. Again, I've left this in the description of the video below. Open up the newly created ADB folder and create a new folder named platform-tools_R30.0.4-Windows. Now open up this newly created folder and create another folder named platform-tools. Now go back to where you extracted the zip folder, copy or cut the content of the folder and paste it into the platform-tools folder that you've created on the C drive. At this point, you can close your browser, and we need to open up the command prompt by typing CMD into the search bar in the bottom left-hand corner of your PC and open up the command prompt. Again, I have left all the commands in the description of the video so you can just copy and paste them to make it easier for you. First, we need to access C drive. Once we see C drive, we want to access the ADB platform tools folder. Next, we want to see if our device can be found, so type ADB device or copy and paste from the link in the description. Here you can see I've found my device R9JN. Now let's go to the ADB shell so that we don't have to access the ADB folder the whole time. You will see that there's no output once you've entered this command. Now we want to find the number of our SD card. So type or copy and paste SM list adoptable. Please take note of this number as we will be using it again. This is mine, 179.64. Next, we want to force our SD card to become an internal storage. So type in or copy and paste SM set-force-adoptable true. Now we could set up variations of the amount of SD card space to be used as internal storage, but in this case, I'm just going to show you how to use the whole thing. From the description of this video, you can just copy and paste the next command. Please remove the brackets and disk ID. Add a colon after the disk and replace it with your SD card information, as I've done with mine. Our last command would be to close the debugging, so please enter or copy and paste the last command. And we are done. All you need.
So before I tell you the last step, I mentioned that there is a great opportunity for you to make money online just using your cell phone. I have placed a link in the description of the video that you can just click on and check it out for yourself. And then the last step would obviously be to follow and subscribe if you have not, please, I beg you. And then just restart your phone. And you should see that your memory has now doubled or even tripled.